Today I've got a list of tips for you guys on non-destructive workflow when working in Adobe Illustrator, but also working in Adobe Photoshop. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content, right here on YouTube. So in today's video, we're going to be looking at tips and techniques for you guys on how to conduct a non-destructive workflow in Adobe Photoshop and Illustrator. In today's video, we're going to be alternating between Photoshop and Illustrator on each single point. So stay tuned and learn how to conduct non-destructive workflow in Adobe software. So like I said, we're going to cover one Illustrator non-destructive tip or technique, and then we're going to look at one in Photoshop, going back and forth throughout this entire video today. So first in Adobe Illustrator, when we make a mistake or we want to step back and undo a move, we press Command or Control Z like so. You may have pressed this multiple times over and realized that you don't have unlimited amounts of undo steps. You go into the Illustrator preferences in the performance section, you can edit the amount of steps you have. If you do choose 200, there's a warning flagged that says it might affect your performance due to take up of memory. If you want to have more opportunities to move back after making a mistake in Illustrator, this is one way you can do it. There is actually a way that you can go into the program files themselves and edit the steps manually for more than 200, but I've not done that yet. We're now going to hop over to Photoshop, and if you look in the preferences window here, you will find in the same area as Illustrator that you can change the amount of undo steps as well. However, here you have more scope for choice. I personally like to set it to around 100 or 200. But anyway, the first Photoshop technique that you need to know for non-destructive graphic design workflow is layer masks. If you don't already use layer masks in Photoshop, now is a great time to start doing so. I've got an image here of a model, and below is a textured background that I want the model to be placed over, without the beige color. Some designers would just grab the eraser tool and take their time to remove it. However, this is destructive workflow, as those pixels will never return again. And what's going to happen later if you realize that you've cut too much of the girl's hair or skin away? So to conduct non-destructive workflow, it's best to add a layer mask. You will then need black and white as the two color palette choices, and then take the brush tool, with black being the foreground color. When you paint over the layer, you're going to erase it. However, it's not actually being erased, you're just masking it. I'm quickly going to show you, but of course, if you're doing this for yourself, you'd want to take the time and the care to cut away the errors properly. You can also take the soft brush and go in closer to the skin. So if you do make a mistake, you can switch to white and paint in the areas like so. So this is the first way to work in Photoshop that is not destructive workflow. The next Illustrator non-destructive workflow tip is a quick one. When we're using the Pathfinder to cut away or create new shapes from other shapes, we place them together and use the Pathfinder functions. But if you do not know already the shape that you want to create precisely, we can lower the opacity of the shapes so we can see the sections cut out. This will speed up your graphic design workflow when working with the Pathfinder tool in this way. So back to Photoshop now. One golden rule when working on photo manipulation or graphics in general is to duplicate the original layer with Command or Control J. This means that you can make edits and changes to your design, and if you decide later that you don't like the results or you make a mistake, the original one is still there at the bottom. In Illustrator, there's a similar technique to this for non-destructive workflow, and is really simple yet essential. Make a copy of the vector shape that you're working on So for example, this V here. I may end up making thousands of changes to this letter, and before I know it, I've ruined the flow of the lettering, and I cannot step back enough undo moves. So make a copy with the Alt Option key, and keep on with non-destructive graphic design workflow. In Photoshop, when we're conducting photo manipulation, we might need to use the dodge and burn tools to enhance highlights and shadows. We could just directly use these tools onto the image itself, but instead create a foreground color of CMYK values of 0, 0, 0 and 50. Then make a new layer and press the Alt Option key and press backspace on your keyboard at the same time. Then go ahead and change the blend mode to overlay. Now you can use the dodge and burn effects on the new layer and they will appear on your design overall. To erase the edits that you've just made, choose the brush tool and the same grey colour that we just used, and then brush over the areas that you don't want. So as you can see here, when I hide the layer, there's a slight change in the grading highlights of the car. This next tip or technique for non-destructive graphic design workflow is a simple one, yet it's vastly important. You can save a copy of your design so that you have the original design and then a design that you have advanced upon. Or you can save multiple designs, as you can see here, instead of saving it with the original design again and again and again. Now you can refer back to various saved documents if you want specific sections of a specific design. In Photoshop, it's always a good idea to convert objects to smart objects. When you scale a smart object up or down, rotate it, or do whatever else to it, it should retain its quality. Unlike with the pixel graphic, you'll find that if you scale it down to a really small size, and then enlarge it again, it's going to become blurred and pixelated. So using smart objects is a good non-destructive workflow technique that you need to be using in Photoshop. The last tip for a non-destructive workflow today is one that I mentioned already in a past video, but it's so crucial and important I need to add it in today's list. It relates to not having to outline text in Illustrator. The issue we can have when saving a PDF or print in Illustrator is that the fonts we use we either not have a license, or more importantly when we send them to the printer, the computer that is used for printing will not recognize the font. So we often outline all the text and save it as a PDF. Problem again with this is that you cannot edit the wording of your text after outlining it. And also if I open up the PDF in Acrobat and access the font section in the preferences, the font is listed here. If the printer does not have this font, there's going to be a big problem when printing your design. There is a way around this, which I'm going to show you now. In Illustrator, go up to Edit and Transparency Flattener Preferences. Click New here, and then drag the raster vector balance all of the way up. You also need to check the Outline option. Oh, and also I forgot to say, you need to add a relevant name, something like outline or something like that. So now your text is still going to be editable, as we haven't actually outlined the text itself. But if you now go ahead and save the PDF, you must use the Acrobat 4 PDF option. And then in the Advanced window, choose the preference that you saved just now. When you export the PDF, you're not going to have any flagged warnings, and the PDF will not have fonts that another computer will not recognize. So essentially, we've outlined the text without actually outlining it. So there is today's video on non-destructive workflow in Adobe Photoshop and Adobe Illustrator. Let me know what you guys thought of today's video down in the comment section below. I always love hearing feedback from you guys, and I want to improve my channel and my videos on a day-to-day basis. So let me know what you want to see on this channel here at Satori Graphics. If you haven't done already, go ahead and subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content just like today's video. Also share it on social media if you do find it really useful. And of course, until next time, design your future today. Peace.